Good morning and welcome. My name is Tracy Brewer, and I will be presenting today's webinar, an overview of UMLR's Component Registry. The purpose of today's webinar is to help new users understand and become familiar with the features and functionality of the Component Registry application. This webinar will last approximately 35 minutes, and throughout the presentation, you will hear me refer to Component Registry as Component Tracking, and component IDs will be referred to as CIDs. Upon completion of this webinar, attendees will be able to register components and view component details, as well as edit and delete components. You'll learn how to associate components and nullify the associations, and also how to query components using predefined queries and advanced query. So what is Component Registry? Well, it's a technology tool for capturing data around railcar equipment components. It operates as a part of the UMLR system and provides rail industry participants visibility into rail equipment health and performance. Also, the application gives users the ability to report on wheel repairs and perform registration for four different component types: wheel set components, bolsters, side frames, couplers, cushioning units, service brake valves, emergency brake valves, slack adjusters, and pressure relief valves. The benefits of Component Registry are centered around safety, productivity, and reduced cost with equipment maintenance and recalls. There are many industry participants that use Component Registry. Wheel shops use it to query and review tagged component IDs. Repair shops supply the registered components and query applied and removed component details. Equipment owners use it to validate billing more effectively. Third-party software providers integrate component tracking capabilities with their own products. And original equipment manufacturers gain more visibility into the equipment and component health status and history. So to gain access to Component Registry, users must first have a Railinc single sign-on account, and then you will need to request the permissions shown here. For full Component Registry access, you need the component maintenance access and UMLR access for query. Many Component Registry users may also perform equipment maintenance, and they will need a few additional roles, such as the UMLR access for maintenance, UMLR advanced query access, and UMLR bulk upload access. The UMLR company administrator must approve the permissions, so be sure to select the correct roles. When selecting the access, indicate the mark that you want the permissions for, and use the apply to all function to carry that mark for all the permissions selected. The company's administrator will review and approve the permissions, and then an email confirmation will be sent once it has been approved. Component registrations are the most frequently performed transactions within the application, and companies have three easy ways to register the component IDs. You can input one component at a time from the web user interface, or enter multiple component transactions using the CSV upload process. And you also have the option of using component tracking web services. This allows for real-time transactional integration, which we will discuss later in the presentation. Railinc's Component Registry application operates as part of the UMLR system. So from the launchpad, select UMLR. When you arrive on the UMLR welcome page, in the main menu bar at the top, select Component Registry, and then select Registration. After selecting registration, you will see four subtabs displayed below the main menu. The search option allows you to search for components that you have registered. The component IDs consist of a four-character company code plus 10 numerics. The company code is assigned to a mark or company ID and its defined location. The component ID number is found on a barcode label pasted directly on the component. If a company reporting mark is two or three characters, Please allow for the extra spaces when entering the 10-digit number. Here, you enter the component ID and search. You can also edit the component if needed. Scroll down the display box to see a preview of the details. And if changes are needed, select the edit function and apply your changes. Here I pressed edit and the base elements of the component appear. After making the change, press save. There is a cancel button if you need to cancel the changes or exit from this view. In the case where a component has been entered in error and should be deleted entirely, you can enter the component ID, select the record by using the checkbox, and then press delete. From there, a pop-up box is displayed to confirm the delete action. Click OK. A success message is displayed when the component has been deleted. Keep in mind, components associated to equipment cannot be deleted. To register a component, select Add New from the submenu. Notice the default company code is Rail, and there's a drop-down menu because Rail has additional company codes for other locations. Once you enter the component ID, select the component type. In this example, I will register a service brake valve, so I'll press Add. If the company code is missing from your screen, please contact our Customer Success Center for it to be added. Mandatory elements will have an asterisk. Always use the calendar icons to select dates and use the drop-down list when provided. Fill in the required data and press Save. Any company that registers a component has the ability to query and view the details that they have registered for 90 days. After you press Save, a confirmation message is displayed, confirming the component was added. If you need to add another component, select Add New right from here. If you need to edit the current component, select Edit, but if finished, select another tab from the main menu to exit from the screen. Next is Field Registrations, under the Registration submenu. The Field Registration search function is often used by repair shops. In the event a component ID label has fallen off or is too worn to read, users can go into the Field Registration search to see if the component has been registered. Most users performing field registrations are generally familiar with the job codes, condition codes, and qualifiers from the AAR field manual. The component registry validates job codes and their related qualifiers and condition codes to ensure correct billing in the car repair billing system. In this example, I entered the required cast month, cast year, and the catalog number. If no matching component is found, select Register to continue registering the component. Also note, for field registrations, each component type may have different mandatory fields for which to search by. Fill in the mandatory fields and any other data that you can read. If you absolutely can't read the label clearly and there's no other way to get the information, the system will allow you to use 9999. In this example, I am field registering a coupler. Once all the required data is saved, select Save. If the validation is successful, the application generates a unique component ID. All field registered components will begin with 8RIC. And notice, after completing the field registration, at the bottom of this screen, you can also associate the component to a piece of equipment. But there are multiple ways to associate a component ID to equipment, and this reporting can be done using the web UI or through Railinc's car repair billing or equipment health management system using repair services. But from the main menu, you can select component registry and then select associate component. First, enter the equipment ID and then select the component type. I've selected coupler. Next, I entered the coupler component ID that I registered earlier, along with the association date, the performer mark or company ID, and the split of the location where it's being applied. Next, select Associate. If the component has no warnings, a confirmation message is displayed and the component is associated to the equipment. Notice you can select the link to view details of the component you just associated. After clicking on View Details, a full pop-up window appears and it displays the component ID, location, equipment number it's associated to, and details of the registered component. Click OK to close this window. In the case where a component ID is already associated to a piece of equipment, a warning message will be displayed. If you click OK, the component ID will still be associated, but a conflict will appear on the equipment record. We will cover how to resolve this type of conflict shortly. Next, to view all component IDs associated to a piece of equipment, type in the equipment ID and click Search. Then in the component drop-down menu, select View All. Here you can see what components have been associated to the equipment you searched. Once the component is associated to an equipment ID, the component is considered a part of the equipment, and all details regarding the component are available to the stenciled mark owner. Components associated to multiple equipment IDs will appear with a red icon symbol, as shown here, along with the other equipment IDs. A new feature that was recently added in Component Registry is the Save As PDF option. This enhancement allows users to save and print any component data you associated to a piece of equipment. Also, owners can print the component association details for all the component types associated to their equipment by using View All. After selecting the Save As PDF function, the system will download the data and save it to your computer so you can print it at your convenience. And if car owners have equipment with component ID conflicts, there are a few things to keep in mind. So from the Umler homepage on the bottom right side of the screen, notice there is a link that takes you to the equipment with component ID conflicts. Those conflicts are informational only, and those conflicts alone will not restrict a car from movement or through interchange. Duplicate components will require physical verification of the component ID that is associated to the equipment. Without physical verification, owners cannot be certain if the component listed in Umler is the same as on the actual equipment. To resolve component ID conflicts, the car owner that confirms the component ID is not physically on their rail car should nullify the incorrect association. Equipment where there are multiple car owners using the same component ID will require additional outreach to multiple owners. Please use findus.rail to locate Umler contact information for car owners and/or their agents. So if there is an incorrect component associated to the equipment, users can perform a nullification which removes the component association from the equipment. The equipment owner or the company who associated the component ID can nullify it. Select Associate Component, enter the equipment ID, and search. From the drop-down menu, select the component type and the associated component ID you wish to nullify. The Nullify option is not available until you select a checkbox beside the associated component. You will receive a pop-up message to confirm you want to nullify the association, and then press OK. If the nullification was accepted, you will receive the confirmation message. And as shown here, the coupler is no longer associated to this car. I mentioned there are multiple ways to register components, and CSV upload files can be used to quickly register multiple components at one time, modify a group of components, or if needed, you can delete a number of components. You must use an acceptable CSV format, which is retrievable from the Upload CSV tab under the Registration submenu. Click the link to retrieve the CSV format templates. For nullifications, select the association template. After entering your component data to the template, save the file and then upload. The required fields for each component type are defined in the Component Registry User Guide and the Data Specification Manual, which is found on the UMLR homepage. For component registrations, the transaction type indicates what action the user wants for each row of the information entered. So to add a component, use AC. To change a component, CC. And delete a component, DC. All mandatory fields must be populated, and all rule validations on the UI are essentially the same with the CSV upload files. In the example shown, three couplers will be uploaded for registration. Click the Browse button to find your saved template, select the file, and then press Submit. After pressing Submit, a message is displayed confirming your CSV file was submitted successfully. If there are any formatting issues, the file would have rejected. An email notification will also be sent to inform the submitter if the data received was processed successfully or if there are any errors, such as invalid data or required data is missing. Those error details will be included in the email. When submitting a CSV upload file for registering, editing, or deleting components, you can use one single upload file and include all three types of transactions. For edit transactions, it requires the component ID and only those fields that require changes, as shown in row 3 of the first image. You can also associate components via CSV. Under the Component Registry main menu, select Associate Component. The transaction type for component association is CA, and for component nullifications, it's CN. In this example, I'm going to associate a component and nullify an association. Select the Upload CSV tab, locate the CSV file, and then submit. When doing a nullification of a component that was associated by your company, you must enter the exact same information as found on the original association. As you can see, the CSV file was successfully submitted, and users will receive an email confirmation that the transactions were processed. Please note the system will not allow an unregistered component to be associated to a piece of equipment. So if the component ID was deleted or not found, the user will receive an error message. So there's a few things to keep in mind when using Component Registry. Field registered components will start with 8RIC, regardless of the shop or company. Repair shops that associate the component will have up to 90 days to view the association details. The equipment with component ID conflicts are informational only and will not restrict the car at interchange. The component conflict can be cleared once another component is associated to either car, or it could be cleared if either association is nullified. Component IDs consist of a 4-character company code plus 10 numerics. So if a reporting mark is 2 or 3 characters, don't forget to allow for the extra spaces when entering the 10-digit number. Next, component tracking allows us to query recalled components. Railinc will maintain component details through existing systems that support criteria related to recall requests. General users do not have the ability to query all recalled components. But if your company registered or associated a recalled component, you can see those using the predefined query, which brings us to our next section. To query registered component IDs entered by your company, From the Component Registry menu, select Query and then Predefined Query. The first option from the predefined query list is to query by components I have registered. Choose your component type and the date range you want to search by, and then submit. Notice the default date range is 30 days from the current date, or you can select Search All Dates. You will receive an email after the query is complete. The email will have a count of how many records were found, and the results of your search will be available in an email attachment. Next, you can query by component IDs associated to my equipment. Here, you also have the option to search by the most current component associated. But if you select Search All Dates, you may get back a lot more data depending on the amount of equipment owners have. However, please note, the components associated to my equipment query and components I have registered query are limited to 50,000 components per request. So if you don't receive an email and suspect your search may exceed that limit, you will need to contact our CSC team and they can assist you with running the report. In the example shown, I only searched within a 30-day period. And if you don't find what you were expecting, you can always change the time frame and retry the query. Next, you can also search by components I have associated in the last 90 days. Choose the component type and submit. And with predefined queries, you have the option to query only recalled components based on the component type. Here again are your email results. And the other query option available from the Component Registry is the Advanced Query. From the Component Registry main menu, select Query and then Advanced Query. This query allows the user to prepare custom queries using multiple criteria with Boolean operators, and that can be saved, run, and edited. When you click on Advanced Query, this new window will open with an option to create a query. Select the Create Query button, and it takes you to the next screen. This is the Query Builder screen. You can select from the options on the left side to insert the fields you want to search by. There's a drop-down menu for each field that lets you select if the corresponding value is equal to, does not equal, is greater than, or less than. But in this example, I have a component ID and I want to know if it's associated to a piece of equipment. So on the left, I'll search by the component ID and then enter the component value. Click Next at the top of the screen. Here you can select the result fields you want to see. Check the box at the top to include the query fields you want returned. So I've selected the component ID and the equipment ID, and then click Next. And then on the last page of the Query Builder, you must enter your name and a brief description, which is optional, and then press Save. You will return to the main Advanced Query screen, and here is where you can select to run, edit, or delete the query. After hitting Run, a highlighted message will appear to inform you that the request is running. Next, you will receive an email when the query is complete. At this point, you can return to the Advanced Query screen and refresh your browser using the Refresh button at the top of the page. When doing so, there will be an additional link under the Actions section for download. And here is where you can select the download link to pull back your results. And as shown on the slide, the component is associated to Rail 6184, which was associated earlier in the presentation. And when you're done, you will have to exit completely from this window and go back to the Umla window. As I mentioned earlier, web services integration is another option for accessing the component registry. If your company is interested in the technical specifications for integrating your products with the Umler Component Registry, please contact our Customer Success Center. To wrap up, I want to share a few of the common questions we receive. One, am I charged for running queries in the Component Registry? And the answer is no. No query fees with that application. Is there a way to see if a component ID is associated to a car? Yes, the advanced query tool can be used to pull back the equipment ID if the component is associated to your equipment. If I need to nullify an association beyond 90 days, how can that be done? Well, by contacting the Customer Success Center, the Umler product support team can assist with nullifying associations beyond 90 days. How can I resolve equipment with component ID conflicts? Well, users can contact the stencil mark owner using findus.rail to inquire if the component is physically associated to their equipment. If the owner confirms there's a different component associated than what is listed in the component registry, the incorrect association should be nullified. As a reminder, on the Umler homepage, you will find a component registry user guide along with the component registry data specification manual, which has an explanation of each element, the permissible values, field length, and limited business rules for entering data. Note also on the homepage at the bottom right side is the equipment with component ID conflicts. Don't forget, car owners can nullify any associations if you confirm that the component is not physically associated to your equipment. If interested in viewing additional resources, users can go to www.railinc.com to access a host of documentation. You can select from the Products and Services menu, and from there, click the link for component tracking. You'll land on the component tracking resource page where you can find helpful documents such as the CSV templates, advanced query user guide, other quick guides, and videos. If you have further questions about component registry or any questions about Umler, please don't hesitate to contact the Customer Success Center for assistance. I want to thank you for your time today and have a great afternoon.